I have a child who is a schizophrenic, who became schizophrenic at the age of 14. She's now 46. And I have 5 other children, and they all have been affected by this. It sort of ruined the family dynamics. When we get together, it's very stressful because of Maggie. So holidays and...
It's okay. It's okay. I propose we start with setting up yourself and your husband. Set them up in the way that they face the audience. All right, sit down. How are you feeling?
I feel this is too close. I feel kind of glued to him. And yeah, I can't go away, but it's too close.
I feel sort of twisted on the inside in a strange way. I feel like turning this way and the same.
Do. And you? How would you move?
I would move out that way.
Okay. Do. Wait. Now we set up the schizophrenic child. That's how a child gets schizophrenic. Let's start like this. How are you feeling now?
I'm still kind of lightheaded and my hands are tingly, but I feel a little more able to breathe.
Tell her, Mom, I let you go.
Mom, I let you go.
Now I let you go.
Now I let you go.
How is that? With the movement, go back. Now you turn. Look forward, yes, go move forward and look forward.
I'm shaky.
The only safe place is a mental hospital.
I'm lightheaded.
Aren't children beautiful? What they try to do for their parents?
Feel a little more safe in the moment.
Wait, here. What's going on with the father?
In the beginning I felt very angry. and I wanted to go and sort of felt tied to this family. I have not much, no compassion for my daughter, like no real warm, no fatherly feelings for her. I have some feelings for her, like when she stood here in front of me, there was a bit of love there, but also anger that she kept me. I wanted to go and she kind of blocked me from going. But there's also some love there. It's not just the one thing, it's both.
Was you?
First, when I was over there, I felt like I didn't even know I had a child. And then when I was in front of him, I felt like that he was very foreign to me. And but I felt like love, but I didn't know what to do with it. I felt like it was a demand on me and I didn't know how to deal with it. And I just felt like distancing myself from it.
And how is it towards the child?
I felt very little relationship with the child at all. Like no feelings, no grief, no.
Now you turn like this. Now you turn again, look at your father. Tell him, I let you go.
I let you go.
Now I let you go.
Now I let you go.
I rely now on people who will care for me.
I rely now on people who will care for me.
Now you turn again. How is it now?
I'm a little better.
Leave it like that, you see? Knock it out of your roles. Yes. Thank you. Get out of your role. No?
With every birth, like when I was born, my mother died. Then when Maggie was born, my grandmother died. And then when Melissa was born, Blanche died.
The important is that your mother died at your birth?
And I almost died then too.
That's it. That's it. You go to your mother. You are drawn back to go to your mother. Of course, you didn't know her.
But your soul did. There's no more intimate relationship than between a fetus and its mother.
We'll set up that too, I suppose. That's important for you, you see. I will do that, you see. I chose somebody for your mother. Choose somebody for your mother. No, I will do that. I will do that.
Just stay still and open.
I'll tell you. Just come here. And I'll take you. That's it. Now look at her. Breathe deeply. And look at her. Go on breathing. Go on breathing. With open mouth. So that the feelings can flow. Go with the feeling. Go. Go. As you come here once more. Now you slip in between the two. You remain, you must be there. Now you embrace them both and you allow yourself that they both unite in your soul. You, your mother and your grandmother unite in your soul. How are you feeling now?
Better. When I was here before, I didn't ever even feel like I had a mom or dad.
Can I do something? Can we do something with that?
Of course. Just sit close. It's okay. Sit close. Yes.
Don't do it alone. Just be still now. Just be still. And let the energy, the warmth, the love, the life of your mother flow through your body to your daughter. And be still. That's it.
All right. I had a strange thought. No? I thought, that's women's power.
Yes.
How are you feeling now?
Better. Better. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. I want to say something about schizophrenia. I think it was most beautifully shown how that develops, you see? How a child has to move to and fro, two different people, and two different tendencies, you see? And it couldn't succeed, you see? Poor child. But that was not the real issue. The real issue came up later, see? That's you and your mother. And schizophrenia can be dealt with in a healing way if the schizophrenic person can unite those opposites, father or mother, or grandmother and mother, as it was here, see? And it flows through you, you see? So that will relieve the child. You can do with her what you just did here, exactly the same way. And you must be aware that your mother is behind you. Okay? Good.
In this work.